Welcome to the SOTI video series. My name is Richard, and this is one of a series of videos about Apple device management with SOTI MobiControl. Please take a look at our various different walkthroughs in this series to see how devices, such as company-owned Apple devices, can be enrolled. But for today, we'll be focusing on how to get an employee-owned device enrolled into SOTI MobiControl. It's important to note as we start that with an account-driven user enrollment, IT administrators can only manage the organization's accounts and settings, never the user's personal account. And the Apple support guidance, as we can see on screen, gives more information about how this protects users' privacy. Before we work through the enrollment process, let's review a checklist of requirements. Firstly, Apple Push Notification Services, or APNS. Second, a managed Apple ID for the employee, and we'll look at this shortly. And thirdly, a SOTI MobiControl enrollment policy, and we'll work through this step by step. Once we have these in place, we can get the device enrolled. So let's get started. Firstly, APNS. It's required for Apple device management, regardless of whether we're looking at a company device or an employee-owned device. And you can review our complete walkthrough on APNS configuration on the SOTI YouTube channel. Secondly, a managed Apple ID. This is created for every employee or staff member within an organization and can be done within Apple Business Manager. Apple IDs have various different uses. For example, more administrative personnel can log in to Apple Business Manager. Or you can also have a staff member login, which is going to be more applicable to the employee-owned device enrollment that we're about to work through. Now, we've referred to the setup of Apple Business Manager in previous videos, so please review those for more information along with Apple's own documentation. For us, we can see that we've already got a managed Apple ID set up. We can see that on screen, and this is the one that we're going to be using for the employee-owned device enrollment in a second. Now let's move on to the SOTI MobiControl enrollment policy. I'll go to the hamburger menu, policies, enrollment, and I'll choose to add a new enrollment policy. I'll choose the option of Apple and choose iOS and iPadOS. Once this is given a name, I'll click Next and I'll choose the enrollment type. And in this case, we're using a user enrollment option. As it says here, user enrollment for BYOD or bring your own device deployments to secure your corporate data on the user's personal device while respecting user's privacy. And we can see underneath this that we can add either a local managed Apple ID, which is the option that we're using today with the Apple ID that's already created on Apple Business Manager, or using a federated option, as it is possible to federate Apple Business Manager with Microsoft Entra ID. And if you're interested in that option, please look at the Apple Business Manager documentation for more information. In our case, I'll choose local account and I'll add in the specific Apple ID that I'm looking to use. But please note, it's also possible to upload a series of these in bulk. So this is the managed Apple ID that we'll be using. We'll click Next and we'll say whether we're looking to have user authentication or not. So for example, selecting a password, either a static password that can be included or a link to a directory. So the individual will need to add their directory credentials as they're enrolling the device. In our case, I'll add a static password that can be added at the enrollment point. From that point, we'll then select the device group that this device will go into once it enrolls. I'll add here our manager devices. Let's say that these are employee-owned devices used by managers. So then it's their own devices, but we're looking to get company applications on those devices, and then click Next. Finally, we'll have the settings, which we can review, change the device name, enable terms and conditions and other options as well, and click Finish. So once this is complete, there's a link to an enrollment URL or a QR code, both of which can be used on the device side to get the device enrolled. Now we've completed the enrollment steps, let's look at the device side experience. And either using the QR code or the enrollment URL would direct us to the screen that we can see currently. And given that we put a password in the enrollment policy, that's the first thing I'm prompted for. Once this is entered, I'll then be prompted to download a series of different profiles, starting with what's known as the Trust Profile. So the Trust Profile is going to contain certificate information, which we'll be able to view in the settings area of the iOS device. I'll click Download to start. I'll then get a prompt to confirm that I'm going to allow the download, which I will. I'll click Download, and we can see that this is now available in settings if we wish to install this. Let's head over to settings on the iOS device, and on the top left-hand side, you'll see that there is a profile that is downloaded. I'll select this, and we can see we have the MobiControl Trust Profile, and this contains three certificates. I can view more details, and I can install on the top right-hand side. I'll be prompted for some sort of identification, such as a passcode or face ID. And then a final install confirmation. That's the first step done. Now let's go back to the web page to see the next step. I'll click Next, and we're next prompted to make sure that the certificate information, which is included in the trust profile, is trusted on the iOS device. And we're given steps about how to make sure this is done by going to Settings, General, About, and Certificate Trust Settings. So I go to General, About at the top. Towards the bottom, we have Certificate Trust Settings. I'll select this and I'll make sure that the certificates that are included in the trust profile are marked as trusted. Now let's go back to the web page one last time. Click Next. And the last step will ask us our managed Apple ID. This is the Apple ID that we referenced in the enrollment policy, and we'll be prompted to download an enrollment profile. Once again, we'll have an allow confirmation. I'll click Allow, and the profile will be downloaded and viewable in the settings area. Towards the top left-hand side, you'll now see there's a section that says Enroll in SOTI MobiControl. User enrollment, verifying my Apple ID, and with the option of Enroll iPad. Once again, I'll be prompted for a passcode. And at this point, I'll be prompted to sign in using the company Apple ID that we've referred to a couple of times previously, so I'll put in my password. Once we've signed in successfully, we'll see that the enrollment is successful and we'll be able to view some information about SOTI MobiControl on the device side. There we are, a successful enrollment message, and we can see SOTI MobiControl is listed on the top left-hand side of the settings area, the settings app on the device. If I click on SOTI MobiControl, you can see once again my managed Apple ID, and we've got information such as the profile and device management settings that are coming across from SOTI MobiControl. If I now move back to the SOTI MobiControl web console, we can see that a new device has been enrolled to our device group. And if I click on the device details, we can see that the enrollment type is marked as user, given that this is a BYOD or employee-owned device. So thank you for joining us in this video where we have successfully enrolled an employee's iOS device into SOTI MobiControl. Now, both company-owned devices and employee-owned devices may have requirements of company applications being provisioned to them. So join us in the next video in this series where we'll explore that subject. For further tutorials, visit and subscribe to the SOTI YouTube channel. And for more information about the SOTI One platform, visit SOTI.net.